Hey, do you have a closet full of clothes and nothing to wear? Today I'm going to talk about how to stop buying the wrong clothes. Hey, welcome to my channel. My name is Netta. My whole goal for this channel is to help you build a wardrobe and a style that you love so that you can look beautiful and feel confident every single day. If that sounds like something you're interested in, definitely hit the subscribe button. We have so much fun here. So today's Tuesday, which means it's Ageless Style Show time. Ageless Style Show is the format for my Tuesday YouTube videos. And in this format, I have a couple of different segments. So let's get into it because I have some fun stuff to cover today. Okay, the first segment I'm going to be featuring is the makeover segment. Often this is a makeover for someone in my program. I show how clothes look in a before and after type of way. So it's a more traditional makeover, or I make over an outfit. But I've introduced a new format for the makeover, which I will be interspersing with viewer makeovers. So I'll be doing I'll be bringing back some of the makeovers on my Ageless Style program members, as well as using these from time to time. So just going to kind of vary that a little bit. If you're interested in submitting something for a makeover, just email support@nettamanley.com and send me a picture of an outfit that is not working for you, or an item that you're having a hard time styling, or a question that I can answer in a future makeover segment. And if I feature it on YouTube, I will send you a little prize, a little present. So anyway, today's makeover is really kind of not so much a before and after, or even a bad and better, but more of a classic versus contemporary way to wear an item. So here is a printed dress, right? Just a pretty printed dress. This is actually a pretty contemporary printed dress, but I know a lot of women have printed dresses in their repertoire, some more contemporary than others. This one happens to be contemporary, happens to be current, and it happens to be pretty flattering, right? Now you can take a contemporary printed dress like this and you can style it one of two ways. So I'm going to give you a couple of options. So in this first look with this printed dress, we have a cardigan, a short classic cardigan with a color that is pulled from the pattern of the dress itself. And then all of the other accessories in this look are also pulled from the pattern. So it's very matching looking. Now, you may like the look of matching, and I will tell you matching is a little bit trendy right now, but over a certain age, matching like so specifically can really look a little bit aging and a little bit frumpy. Especially, again, these pieces are all contemporary, they're all pretty cool, but if any of the pieces is not like super modern, then this can be a hard look to pull off. So she's got, you know, there's a matching cardigan, there is a matching shoe, and a matching bag. And all of the pieces are classic, except for, like I said, the dress is kind of contemporary, but the cardigan is classic, the ballet shoes are round toe classic ballet shoes, the bag is kind of a classic little sack bag. And so since none of the pieces are really directional or really contemporary or really modern, those classic colored pieces matching with the floral dress can look a little bit too matchy-matchy, too pulled together. And looking too pulled together in that way can read a little bit aging. Again, if you were 20 and you wore this, fine. But you know, 30, you can wear whatever you want when you're younger, because it's not going to look aging on you. But at over 50, it can look like a little bit matronly when you wear all of these colors matching. So let me give you another idea on how you could style the same dress. So instead of a cardigan, and that cropped, you know, cardigan worn as a topper is not really contemporary right now. If you do have those waist length classic cardigans like many of us do, button it up and wear it as a top on its own, but don't wear it with a matching dress. So I've added two neutral jackets, you know, show you different options with this printed dress. So one of the jackets is neutral, but it does actually pull a color from the dress. It's got that, you know, green tone from the dress, but it's a neutral jacket. It's a contemporary kind of slouchy fitting jacket, and it's just a more modern look. It also counteracts the frilliness and the femininity of the dress with a more tailored shape, right? So you've got that balance between the two shapes. And so it's not sweet on sweet on sweet on sweet, which was also one of the things that made the first look a little harder to wear. Then I also have a neutral, solid neutral, like off-white jacket with this. Either would work. You could even do, you know, you could do whatever neutral color that you wanted in a jacket and top it. Top the dress with a blazer instead of a cardigan. Then I wanted to elongate the leg line and also choose a more contemporary shoe. So I chose a nude flat rather than matching the color of the dress. We're matching the color of the skin. So, you know, you can choose a nude shoe with any dress and it's going to elongate your leg. Also, the fact that this is a pointy shoe that shows the top, most of the top part of the foot. It's got a little strappy detail for extra interest, but that's going to be extra elongating. It's got the pointy toe and a neutral nude color. So instead of matching the color of the dress, we are matching the color of the skin. Then I also chose a neutral bag in a really contemporary and cool shape. So again, this is an instant outfit update. If you have printed dresses languishing in your closet that you don't know what to wear with, you can top them with any neutral blazer. You can top them with a utility jacket. You can top them with a denim jacket, and you're going to instantly update those pieces. Add a pair of flattering flats or pumps or whatever shoe silhouette that you like in a nude color and a neutral bag, and you're going to have a much more contemporary look. So again, we're going from classic and potentially matronly to a more contemporary and easy update for all of the printed pieces that are in your wardrobe. Let me know if seeing these different options helps you kind of accessorize the things that are in your own closet in a new way. If you've been wearing the same pieces in the same ways, you may find that you're just bored of what you've got. And all you really need is a couple of accessories and maybe permission to mix it up a little, right? Okay, so that's today's makeover segment. Again, if you want to submit something of your own for this segment, definitely email me at support@nettamanley.com. I can't wait to hear from you. I love getting emails and questions from you guys that I can answer in future episodes. So definitely don't forget to send me an email. Okay, next segment I want to launch into is Buzzworthy. Buzzworthy is where I feature something that's on my radar that week that I have been loving and that I want to share with you. So today's Buzzworthy is something called the Illuminage sleep set. So I know everyone's heard about silk pillowcases and silky pillowcases and the benefits of those pillowcases for your skin and for your hair. Illuminage actually has, it's a polyester silky feeling, but it's a polyester blend pillowcase that has copper threads built into the fibers. So I have been using this pillowcase. It was sent to me, the set. The set, just so you know, the pillowcase and the sleep mask together are $94. They're not inexpensive, but they last a really, really long time. I was probably sent this set a couple of years ago, and I use it every single day. So this is my go-to pillowcase. I wash it and put it right back. I wash it and put it right back. So, and the sleep mask, I don't use the sleep mask as regularly as the pillowcase. I don't use sleep masks that often, but I definitely would recommend this one. It is really, really comfortable for those of you who prefer to sleep with a sleep mask on. So I actually gave it to my husband and he loved it because he does use them because I keep the lights on after bedtime. But anyway, what I love about these pillowcases is that there is no tugging and wear and tear on your skin and on your hair. I have hair that tends to get messed up very, very easily. It's very frizz prone. I only wash it like every third day. So the in-between days, I'm sleeping with my hair up, but it can still get like roughed up. It can still get frizzy. It can still get flyaway. And so I like to make sure to protect it as much as possible. And a silky pillowcase, honestly, any silk pillowcase will help with the hair challenge and really just kind of keep your hair looking nicer overnight. With the skin, we want to prevent tugging as much as possible. Unfortunately, I'm a side sleeper and I'm honestly considering one of those pillows now that has the groove in it so that your face is not pressed up against your pillow. I start on my back many, many nights and then I end up on my side. And I know how aging it can be to sleep on your side. I sleep on my right side. I definitely see more signs of aging on my right side than my left side. But I will tell you, since I started sleeping on this pillow, I feel like I wake up, I don't get the creases on my face. I don't wake up with my face looking smushed. It definitely is gentler and easier on your skin. The copper fibers that are woven into the fabric are really supposed to help with creasing and aging, and they say in as little as 4 weeks you can see an improvement in your skin. So I definitely recommend, if you have not invested in one of these pillowcases, these anti-aging pillowcases, definitely recommend trying them out. I've really, like I said, really noticed a big difference. We spend hours every night sleeping, and if you're pushing your face up against, like I am, against, you know, cotton or linen or a fabric that's got any kind of grip to it, you are doing unnecessary damage to your skin and your hair. So definitely recommend looking into one of these anti-aging pillowcases. Okay, my next segment is the question of the week. Now the question of the week, as I've been doing the last couple of weeks, is going to be answered with today's main topic, right? Okay, so these questions are kind of loosely related to the topic today, but I thought that they kind of got to the heart of what is happening when many of us struggle with style. So the first question is from Susan. She's 60. She says, I tend to purchase a single item that I love, but fail to find the remaining outfit pieces. So I often have items in my closet that I never wear. So she is a kind of an impulse shopper. She sees something that she loves and she buys it, and then she gets it home and she realizes she doesn't have anything to wear with any of those pieces, and so it hangs in her closet, right? Finding clothes that fit right and look nice on me is a challenge. This is from Lisa Marie. She's 54. She struggles with finding clothes that fit right and look nice on her. Okay, so what is the challenge here? The challenge is shopping. The challenge is shopping successfully and strategically. And in order to shop successfully and strategically, you need to stop buying the wrong clothes so that you have money, time, energy, etc., to buy the right clothes, right? So that's the focus of today's video. How to stop buying the wrong clothes. So I'm going to start by saying that the solution that Susan is looking for, with all of the one-off pieces in her wardrobe that don't match anything else, is my essentials checklist. If you go to nettamanley.com/essentials, you can sign up for it there. You will get my downloadable PDF with essentials broken down by decade. If you've got statement or interesting pieces in your wardrobe, they go with all the essentials. You don't need to buy. I remember back in the 80s going shopping at Bernheim's with my mom. We would have to buy the entire look. Right? Like I remember very clearly buying this outfit from a brand called Santa Cruz. It was a printed top and a printed skirt. Printed top and a printed skirt and a solid vest with the colors from the top and the skirt. And then I got the earrings and I got the bracelet. And then we stopped and got shoes, because that was how you did it in the 80s, right? It's not like that anymore. If you've got an interesting top or an interesting skirt and you feel like you don't have that missing piece to complete that and to turn it into an outfit, I guarantee you, you probably do. You need to put it with something neutral and solid and simple. You need to put it with one of the essential pieces from my essentials checklist, and it will turn all of those statement pieces into outfits, okay? So just a quick aside before I launch into the main topic. So why do we buy the wrong clothes? These are the things that we might be doing that are causing us to buy things that we're not wearing and we're not loving. The first tip is to stop shopping under duress. Stop shopping under duress. Don't shop when you absolutely need something to wear to X, Y, or Z, because you're going to end up with things that you don't love, things that you won't wear again, things that you've wasted your money on. When we're forced to buy something for an occasion, we are forced to spend whatever it takes. We're forced to compromise sometimes to get that item. It might be something that we don't love, we never plan on wearing again, but we just feel like we need it for that occasion. Whereas if we've taken the time to shop a little bit more strategically, and if we had those gaps filled in our wardrobe to begin with, we wouldn't need to shop for an occasion or an event. I'm very anti shopping for an occasion or an event in most cases. Obviously, there are going to be situations, mother of the bride, mother of the groom, your own wedding. But most of us don't have to shop event specifically, trip specifically, or anything like that if we're pulling together wardrobes that are well-rounded and that fill, that check all of those boxes for us, okay? So don't shop under duress. It is the easiest way to waste a lot of time and money and still end up with something you don't love. Second is buy it when you see it, not when you need it. This is very closely related to the previous tip. Buy it when you see it, not when you need it. I am fond of saying all the time that I buy cocktail dresses in the off season at Last Call or Neiman Marcus or Nordstrom Rack or Off Fifth. I buy a beautiful cocktail dress or a beautiful formal dress when I see it at a great price, a dress that I love in my size. Like, you know, I've told this story before, but I found at Last Call, I found a Dion Von Furstenberg silk wrap gown in navy, beautiful classic piece that I will have forever. I bought it at Last Call for like $60. Crazy. They had one, it was in my size. That's when you buy those pieces. You don't wait until you've got the if you're the type of person who will ever go to a formal event. I mean, if formal events or cocktail parties are never part of your lifestyle, I still suggest having a couple of dressy dresses. But for me, they are part of my lifestyle. And so having that dress that's hanging there that I know that I can pull out when the formal event comes around is so valuable. So buying the items when you see them and not when you need them. I recently went shopping with a family member for a black short sleeve top, which you would think it would be easy to find a black short sleeve blouse. Not a tee, she wanted a black short sleeve blouse for a funeral service. You'd think that that would be the easiest thing in the world to buy. It is not the easiest thing in the world to buy when you're looking for it in July in Florida and you've got a couple of hours. It's not. We found a lot of tees. We found sleeveless. We found long sleeve, but we didn't find any black short sleeve tops. So it's very hard to find those specific items when you're looking for them. If you're looking for a great pair of black pants, it's going to be harder to find them, you know, running around town trying to find that specific pair of black pants. If you run into them at a store, even when you're not looking, a basic pair of pants in your dark neutral, that's when you need to be buying them. So again, shop when you find, or buy something when you find it, not when you need it. When you need it, it's too late. Okay. The third thing I want to say is focus on fit and flattery. Now, we can compromise on a lot of things, but we don't want to compromise on things being flattering and fitting us well. So what happens, again, when we're shopping under duress or when we're shopping for a specific event, a lot of times we will buy things that are compromises. And I say this over and over again in my videos, but you don't want a closet full of compromises. You want a closet full of home runs, of winning items that you absolutely love and that fit and feel beautiful. So if you are compromising on fit and flattery, you're never going to be happy with your wardrobe. So that's an area that you cannot afford to cut corners on. So when you're trying something on, pay attention to the quality, pay attention to the fabrication, pay attention to the care labels, like how are you going to be able to maintain this item? Is it going to involve ironing? Do you iron? Like all of those things, really be intentional with your purchases. And then really, does it flatter you and does it fit you beautifully? If it fits you almost, you know, like 95%, but it's a little long or there's a little detail on it that can be altered, will you take it to be altered immediately, preferably on the way home from the store? You want to ask yourself those questions. Many of us are going to have our clothes altered, especially those of us who are petite. So you're going to have to make that commitment to yourself. If you buy something that's perfect in every way, but it's a little bit long, that you're going to have to take it to get altered, because fit and flattery are the two things that we cannot compromise on. Another aspect of flattery is choosing colors that really make you look beautiful without having to wear a ton of makeup just to compensate for a bad color, right? So you want to be really intentional about those details and about choosing things that are going to make you look and feel beautiful at the store, not bringing anything home that's a compromise. Next is start with the essentials. I kind of mentioned this in when I was talking about Susan's dilemma of having a bunch of things that don't go with anything else. If you start with the essential pieces in your wardrobe, these are the pieces that are never going to be the wrong clothes. You will never regret buying basic solid pieces or basic neutral pieces. You'll never regret them. If they fit you well, the quality is good, they're comfortable, and they suit your personal style, you'll never regret them. No one has ever regretted buying a pair of neutral pants that are flattering and comfortable. Like, that will never be something you regret. We regret the kind of crazy out there items sometimes, or the items where we wanted a great pair of jeans and we bought a ho-hum pair of jeans. We wanted a great pair of black pants and we bought a ho-hum pair of black pants. These are the things, again, when we're talking about not compromising, you especially don't want to compromise when you're shopping for essentials, because these are the pieces that you're going to wear over and over and over again. They're the workhorse pieces of your wardrobe, and you want them to make you feel and look beautiful. You want them to be easy. You want them to be easy to care for. You want them to be great quality, you want them to be flattering, all of the things, right? Again, I'm kind of repeating myself with this next one, but don't compromise, don't buy it unless you love it. So talking yourself into clothes at the store, you're not gonna love it anymore when you get it home, right? If you're not already in love with the piece before you buy it, it needs to stay at the store. So we are used to just buying things because we're bored, we're tired, we're in a bad mood, we need a little lift, etc., etc. And then we end up again with a closet full of compromises. If you don't love it, don't buy it. And granted, essentials, a white tee, a black tee, a pair of black pants, whatever, they're not going to be the kinds of things that make your heart go a flutter, but you want to love the quality, the fit, and the feeling of that item anyway. Even if it's not like a showy, flashy piece that makes your heart go a flutter, you still want to love the way that piece fits and the versatility it's going to bring to your wardrobe. So if you don't love something, leave it at the store. You've got enough clothes that are hanging in your closet that you don't love. They don't need any more company, right? Okay, the final tip, and this is something that can really change the way that you approach shopping in general, is to ask yourself with every item that you buy, and I will tell you right now, spoiler alert, the essentials will check all of these boxes, but if you can wear the item three different ways and to three different places. So, for example, say you're looking at a silky blouse in a neutral color. Can you wear it to work, to weekend, and to church? Awesome, you can wear it to three different places. Can you wear it with your jeans, with your pencil skirt, and with your flowy statement skirt? Awesome, you can wear it with three different pieces in your wardrobe. So, you know, when Susan indicated that she was bringing home pieces and not having anything to wear with them, it's because you don't have those essential pieces. So if you have the essential pieces in your closet, you should have that mix and match ability with most of the things you bring into your wardrobe. But that's a question, that's a gatekeeper for shopping in, for anything in your wardrobe. You want to ask yourself, can I wear this three different ways, and can I wear it with three different places and three different ways with three different types of outfits? So if it checks those boxes, or most of those boxes, then this is going to be something that you can safely and comfortably and confidently bring into your wardrobe, knowing it's going to be something that's going to be there for some time, that you're going to wear and that you're not going to regret buying. You're going to love, you're going to use, you're going to feel beautiful in. If it doesn't check these boxes, then consider leaving it behind at the store. You don't need any more clutter in your closet. None of us need to bring clothes into our closet just so we can purge them out again in 6 months. Like, that vicious cycle is something we all need to be really conscious of and to stop doing. We want wardrobes that are going to build wardrobes that are going to last for years to come and make us look and feel beautiful. So I hope that was helpful. Just some strategies for you to take with you when you're shopping, and to be more intentional in our purchases, not compromise. You deserve to look and feel beautiful every single day in your clothes, and that's not going to happen with the wrong clothes hanging in your closet, cluttering your life. It's not going to happen by making the wrong purchases at stores. So let me know, what's your strategy for not buying the wrong clothes? What did you think of the tips shown here? I'd love to hear from you guys, so definitely let me know in the comments. As always, it means so much to me that you hang out with me here. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. It's free, and we have so much fun. Also, hit the notification bell. You'll find out when I upload new videos, which is every Tuesday, every Friday, and I will see you in the next video.